गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स. हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू माई मैथमेटिक्स क्लास विद योर आशु मैम. एंड वी आर डूइंग अर्थमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन टूडे. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स विच हैव स्टार्टेड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो विद यू. सो 5.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. आई टॉट यू द फर्स्ट टू पार्ट्स इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. Now let us discuss the remaining parts of question number 4, exercise 5.1. So let's start. So dear students, let us read question number 4 once again. Which of the following are APs? The very first part we have to check whether these are APs or not. Then if they form an AP, find the common difference D and write 3 more terms. So let us start doing the question now. So to check whether this is an AP or not, you all know that we have to find out the common difference, like D1, D2, minimum 3 common difference we will find out. So D1 is A2 minus A1, D2 will be written as A3 minus A2, and D3 will be A4 minus A3. So let us put the values. A2 is minus 3.2, then a minus from the formula, and then A1 is again negative, so we will put the bracket here. So similarly, A3, that is minus 5.2, then minus from the formula, then A2 is again a negative term, so we will keep it in the bracket. Then A4 is minus 7.2 minus of, then A3 is minus 5.2. So this step is very important, that this negative sign is of the formula and this negative sign is along with the terms. So dear students, let us solve it. Minus 3.2 minus minus plus 1.2. So as you can see, how plus minus is minus. So 3.2 minus 1.2. 3.2 minus 1.2 will be, so you can subtract it like this. Let me explain you once. So minus karenge, 2 minus 2 is 0. Decimal ke niche decimal, 3 minus 1 is 2. So you will get 2.0 means 2, but the greater number is of negative sign, so we will place a negative. So this is the D1. Similarly, second will be minus 5.2 minus minus plus 3.2. So again the greater number is negative, we'll take minus. 5.2 minus 3.2, again you will get minus 2. So let us do the third one. Minus 7.2 minus minus plus 5.2 is equal to minus 2 again. So dear students, because D1 is equal to D2 is equal to D3, and that is equal to common D, and the value is minus 2. So difference humne nikal liya. So this implies this is an AP. This series of number is an AP. Now the first part is done. Second part, we have already found out the common difference. Then third is to find out the next 3 terms. So what are the next 3 terms? Up to 4 it is given to us. Now we will write A5, A6 and A7. So A plus 4D, A plus 6D and A plus 7D. So what is the value of A? The first term will be considered as the A, minus 1 by 1.2. Then plus 4 into D is minus 2. So again solve it. Minus 1.2 plus minus minus 4 2s are 8. So both are negative. We will add them, minus minus plus, but we will place minus sign for this. So 8, this you will get minus 9.2. I hope you know how to add it. It is a decimal number, but it is without decimal, so we can write it as 8.0. So from here we can get 9.2. both are negative, so minus 9.2, right? Similarly, solve the remaining two terms. So this is a6 is a plus 5d and a7 is a plus 6d. By mistake, I have written 6 and 7 here. So by solving it, we'll get the three values, next three values as this. So this is the solution. Now next part. Now dear students, do fourth part yourself. It is just similar to this. Try it yourself. Now let's do the fifth part. In this, the series of number is given as 3, 3 plus root 2, 3 plus 2 root 2, 3 plus 3 root 2. Four terms are given to us. So let us find out whether this is an AP or not. How? By finding out the difference between the consecutive terms. So A2 is 3 plus root 2, then a minus, then A1 is 3. So by solving it, dear students, this is plus 3, this is minus, you will get root 2. This is the first difference. Then A3 is 3 plus 2 root 2, then a negative sign. Dear students, as you can see in these terms, there are, in these values, there are two terms, means binomials are there. So when you place this negative sign and you will put A2, place it in the bracket, because A2 is a binomial. 3 plus root 2, it carries two terms. So when we open the bracket, because negative sign is outside the bracket, the sign of both the terms will get changed. If you do not place the bracket, to kya hoga? Sirf 3 minus ka banega. But if you place the bracket, to dono hi terms negative aajenge. How? So 3 plus 2 root 2 plus minus minus 3 minus plus minus root 2. So plus 3 minus 3 cancelled out. Now this is root 2 term, this is root 2. Dono root 2 and these are like terms. So we will combine their coefficients here. 2 root 2. Here nothing is there, that means 1 root 2. So 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2. 2 mein se 1 gaya, we're left with only root 2. So this is second common difference. Now similarly, A4 is 3 plus 3 root 2, then a negative sign, then place the value of A3 in the bracket. 3 plus 2 root 2 is equal to, let's open the bracket, 3 plus 3 root 2 as it is, then minus plus minus 3 minus plus minus 2 root 2. Again opposite sign cancel out, and 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2, again like terms, square root same hai, like terms. 3 minus 2 is 1 root 2, that is root 2. So as you can see, all the differences are same. So we will write d1 is equal to d2 is equal to d3, that is that the difference is common and it is equal to root 2. So hence, yes, this is an AP. Now let us find out the next three terms. So next three terms will be as a5 a6 a7 a5 a plus 4d, that is a is the first term, that is 3 plus 4d, d is root 2. Similarly, a plus 5d is 3 plus root 5, a plus 6d is 3, that is a plus 6 into d is root 2. So this is the answer. Now let's do the next part. So dear students, here is sixth part. The series is, list of numbers is 0.2, 0.22, third term is 0.222, fourth term is 0.2222. So let us find out their common difference. So A2 is 0.22, then minus A1, 0.2. So let us do its subtraction in the rough. Draw a margin line for rough area on the same page. Play a 0, decimal. Decimal ke niche decimal likhna hai and subtract it. Here no digit is there, so we'll take 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. 2 minus 2 is 0.0. So this will be 0.02. Similarly, A3 is 0.222 minus 0.22. So let us subtract it. 0.222, 0.22. Again, 22 is there, we'll take a 0. So to subtract it, we'll get 200.0. So 0.002. So dear students, as you can see, the first difference and second difference are not same. So no need to calculate the third one. Directly we can write as D1 is not equal to D2. Here 0.02 and here 0.002. They are not equal. This implies this is not an AP and the question ends up here. No need to solve it further. Now do seventh part yourself. It is a general series numbers, nothing is different. So do it yourself. Be careful about the negative sign given along with the numbers, okay? So while finding out the difference, be very careful. Now let me solve this fraction series. So it is given as first term -1/2, second term is -1/2, all the terms are same. So let us check whether this is an AP or not. So let us find out the common difference. A2 is -1/2, then a negative sign of the formula, then A1 is again negative, so we will keep it in the bracket. So -1/2, -, +1/2. So this is -1/2, this is positive, cancelled out, we'll get 0. Similarly, in each case, dear students, because all the values are same, so all the differences will be 0, right? इसी तरह से बाकी की भी सभी values क्या हो जाएंगी? 0. So as D1 is equal to D2 is equal to D3 and the common difference is 0. So this is an AP. And if it is an AP, so let us find out its remaining terms. A5, A6, A7. A5 is A+4D, A+5D, A7 is A+6D. So let us quickly, what is A? The first term is -1/2. Then +4 and D is 0. And you know 0 multiplied by anything is 0. So -1/2 plus 0 is -1/2. Similarly, we'll get each and every value as same. So because the common difference is same in each case, so each value will be same. So in this way, you will be able to find out all the values of the remaining three terms because this is an AP. Now dear students, try ninth part yourself. This is very easy question. Normal values are given to you. Do it yourself. Now 10th part, the terms are given to us as A, 2A, 3A, 4A and so on. So all four terms, let us find out common difference. A2 minus A1 means 2A minus A. That both are like terms. Ye bhi A wali term hai, ye bhi A wali. So 2a minus 1a is equal to a, 3a minus 2a is equal to a, 4a minus 3a is a. Because all are same, that means this is an AP. Now fifth term, a plus 4d, what is a? In the series, a is itself a. So in place of a, we'll write a plus 4 into d. D ki value bhi kya hai hai? A. So a plus 4a, both are like terms. Yahan coefficient kya hai? 1 hai, both are like terms, so 4 plus 1a is 5a. Similarly, a plus 5a is 6a and a plus 6a is 7a. So in this way, the question is very easy. Do it, try it yourself. Now dear students, in 11th part, there is a twist given to us that the series of numbers are given in the form of powers. A raised per 1, A raised per 2, A raised per 3, A raised per 4. So let us see how to solve it. So let us start finding out the common difference. What is A2? A2 is A square minus A1 is A. So dear students, this is a square term and this is A raised per 1. They are not like terms. We can't add or subtract them. Hum inhe solve nahi kar sakte. A square minus A raised per 1 ko A nahi likh dena. Wo 2A minus A tha. Yahan par A square minus A hai. तो हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व इट? टेक आउट ए एज अ कॉमन फैक्टर. जिसकी पावर कम होती है वो कॉमन आ जाता है, ए रेज पर 1. सो ए स्केयर में से ए बाहर गया, व्हाट इज लेफ्ट? ए, देन माइनस साइन एंड इट हैज़ टेकन एज अ कॉमन फैक्टर, सो नथिंग इज लेफ्ट, दैट मीन्स 1. सिमिलरली ए क्यूब, ए3 इज ए क्यूब माइनस ए स्केयर. Again, this is a cubic term, this is a square term. We can't combine them, we can't subtract them. So let us take out commons. What is the smaller power? A square. Smaller, so smaller power will be taken out. What is left out of cube? Square gone out. Only A is left, minus. Complete A square gone out, 1 is left. So as you can see, it is A raised to power 1, here A square. Brackets are same, but here A and here A square. So this implies, we can say no need to solve the next part. ये करने की ज़रूरत नहीं, सीधा क्या लिखेंगे? As D1 is not equal to D2, this is not an AP. That's it. This is the end of this question. Now dear students, 12th part is this. Root 2, root 8, root 18, root 32. Square roots are given to us. But before taking their common difference, dear students, we have to solve their square roots now. We have to solve their square roots now. So let us solve. Root 2 will remain as it is because it's a prime number, can't split further. For root A, you can do the prime factorization. 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. So one pair is common, so we'll take it out, and this is left unpaired, we'll keep it inside. Right? Similarly, let us solve for 18. 2 9s are 3, 3 3 1s are. So this, jiska pair ban jata hai, wo bahar aa jayega, and which is left unpaired will remain inside. Similarly, let us solve root 32. 2 16s are 32, 2 8s are 16, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. A pair from here, a pair from here. So, yahan se ek 2, yahan se ek 2. 2 2s are 4, and this is left unpaired, it will remain inside. So, in this way, dear students, you will get the square roots of these numbers. Now, we will solve it in the same way as we have done earlier. So, let us see the solution. So, A2 is 2 root 2 minus A1 is root 2. Now, both the roots are same, we can combine them. 2 root 2 mein se 1 root 2 minus karenge, we'll get root 2. But agar aap root 8 mein se root 2 minus karte, these roots are not similar, hum solve nahin kar paate. That's why we have solved the square roots first. In the second case, 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2 is again 2. In third case, 4 minus 3 is again root 2. So as the difference is same, D1 is equal to D2 is equal to D3, and that is D is equal to root 2. So yes, this is an AP. This is an AP. So if it is an AP, so let us find out the square roots. A is root 2 plus 4. D is again root 2. So 4 plus 1 root 2 is 5 root 2. From here we'll get 6 root 2. From here we'll get 7 root 2. So in this way, you can solve it.